Extracting genomic DNA for PCR can be expensive and time-consuming, but the HotSHOT method is a quick, inexpensive option to extract PCR quality DNA from a range of different tissues. Hi, I'm Brian Douglas from Bento Lab. In this video, I'm going to show you the HotSHOT DNA extraction method, explain the pros and cons, and I will also give you a quick demo. The HotSHOT method is a simple two-step protocol performed in a single PCR tube. The first step is an incubation step in hot dilute sodium hydroxide, followed by pH adjustment with a neutralizing buffer. The protocol was originally developed in 2000 by Dr. Gary Truett and his team for routine genotyping of mouse tissues. Today, it's widely used in many different applications because of its low cost, simplicity, and scalability. So what makes HotSHOT such a useful method? It's very cheap. The cost per reaction is between 5 and 10 cents per sample, depending on the sample size. This makes it ideal for low-cost approaches. The method is very versatile. In addition to extracting DNA from animal tissue, studies have shown that it can work for a wide variety of other tissue types, such as zooplanktonic eggs, pollen, and fungal pathogens in plant tissues. What's also great about this method is it's very rapid. You can go from fresh sample to DNA extract in 30 minutes. The end result is a DNA extract that can be used for PCR assays, sequencing, and DNA barcoding. It is easily scalable, so you can use it for a few samples or with 96 well plates. If it's so cheap and quick, why doesn't everyone use the HotSHOT method for every sample? It's important to bear in mind that the HotSHOT method is a relatively crude way to extract DNA. This is fine if it works for your purpose, but there might be scenarios where you need a more sophisticated method of DNA extraction. The key reason it may not work is because of PCR inhibitors, or you may be working with a sample with low concentrations of DNA. If your sample has a high proportion of PCR inhibitors, then the HotSHOT method may extract DNA, but the inhibitors will stop any PCR reaction from working. If this is the case, you can try adding reagents to bind the PCR inhibitors, such as the additive BSA. In addition, you could try diluting the DNA extract in order to reduce the impact of the inhibitors. You also need to know that the HotSHOT method produces highly fragmented, single-stranded DNA. This is suitable for PCR, but not for applications where a high yield of unfragmented DNA is required, such as whole genome sequencing. Now let me give you a quick demo. I'll be using the Bento HotSHOT kit. I've prepared a very small sample of lamb liver. First, I'll be adding a very small amount of alkaline lysis solution to a PCR tube. Then I will add the sample. Next, the sample has to be incubated at 95 degrees centigrade. Around 30 minutes should be enough to release the DNA. After incubation, I'll be adding the neutralizing buffer. Once this is done, the liquid in the PCR tube is a DNA extract in a pH buffer suitable for long-term storage and for use as a DNA template in PCR. So to summarize, the HotSHOT method is a simple, cheap, two-step process that can extract DNA from lots of sample types. Depending on your application, the HotSHOT method might be a great choice for you. You can find links to the papers and to the Bento HotSHOT DNA extraction kit in the description below. If you want to see a step-by-step guide through the method, you will also find a dedicated video for that. If you like this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. If you have any questions, please leave a comment. We would love to hear from you. Thank you.